the imagination of the color schemes on them so far out? I would say art and imagination, the two.
People have that typical idea in their head about what is a chopper. And that's why we have the first one in the room made by Mondo, which is a very long, stretched out front end, tank pointing up into the stratosphere, king and queen seat and a sissy bar and that laid back look. It's like you saw in Easy Rider.
Get your motor running.
The chopper basically is a motorcycle that is art.
It's amazing, it's beautiful. The artwork, the fabrication. Yeah, gotta go
make it happen. I juxtaposed the portraits of each artist who made each motorcycle with their work and included a lot of documentary photographs that I made of them in their own milieu so that you could get, as I call it, an idea of the high priests of horsepower. They're lane-splitting libertarians on the road to perdition with a consummate sense of style. Heavy metal thunder, racing with the wind. You know, each one of these artists who made this, or each third-party owner, collector who rides it, is really the trustee of a piece that will extend, as I said, into generations in the future, or just as a painting. You don't really own it, you're taking care of it, and you pay for that privilege and you share it with other people, and that's what we're trying to do with all of these motorcycles. We want to share them with the public. Born to be wild. I hope to get across the idea that this is an art form. One that is as indigenous to America as is jazz, or rock and roll, or a Hollywood movie. I want people to understand that this is art that needs to be conserved for generations to come so that they can enjoy it the same way that we do.